Hello, my name is Christina, and at this tutorial we will see the ways we can add and edit Thea materials inside SketchUp with the use of Thea for SketchUp plugin. Let's start by opening an example SketchUp scene. This scene has been set up with SketchUp materials only, but Thea can handle and render them correctly without any additional modifications to them. Let's see that by opening the main rendering window by pressing the third button of the Thea toolbar. Here, we can select the engine that we want to be used, enable if we want the interactive render and the overlay option, and by pressing the start button we see the rendering to start inside SketchUp viewport. As you see, all SketchUp materials with their textures and their defined transparency are being rendered correctly. But Thea materials compared to SketchUp materials have some additional features such as reflectance, bump map, displacement, etc. We can use Thea materials inside our scene to make even more photorealistic renders. There are several ways for doing that. We can tweak the existing SketchUp materials, or we can use the advanced Thea material editor to create our own materials, or select a ready-to-use material from the available Thea material libraries. Let's see one by one these ways. For using the Thea material presets, we press the first button of the Thea toolbar, we open the Thea tool window, and we go to the Materials tab. We see now that with Thea cursor, we can click on our scene and select the materials we want, or alternatively find them in the drop-down list here, and see their settings appearing inside the Material tab. Let's say we want to change the material used at our windows to make it more realistic. We click on it, and then we see the drop-down list with the material presets. The name of each preset gives us an indication on the kind of the material that will be created. For our case, we select the thin glass option. We simply click on it, and the material preset has been applied. We can confirm this by making an example render. As you see, the material has changed, and it has now reflectance as well. At any point we want, we can go back to the SketchUp material by right-clicking on the preview and press the Remove Thea Material button. Let's re-add the material preset to the window and give an additional example with a different material this time. Let's say we want to change the material used at the pool ladder. We click on it with the Thea cursor and we go once again to the list of the material presets. For this case, we select the colored metal. We simply click on it, and we see that the material now at the pool ladder has changed to a metallic one. Note that below each preset, several settings appear that allow further material modification. For example, with the use of these settings, we can load an external texture as a bump up of one of our materials. Let's click on the wall material. From the presets list, we can leave the default one, as this is a pure diffuse material. By clicking on the SU button, you can open a new menu and change, for example, the color of the material. By pressing the SU button once again, you can decide to choose SketchUp material again or an external texture, like in the case of the bump map, where with this button we can open the texture file window and load an external texture for our bump map. Note that the external texture, once specified, can be imported into SketchUp by right-clicking on the Ext button and select the Import Texture option. The imported texture size will be automatically reduced. If we want, we can change then the percentage of this bump map, and by making an example render, see that the new material is being used to our scene. With the use of the material presets, we can start from the same default SketchUp material and create easily several Thea material variations, as we see here. Another way to add and edit Thea materials inside SketchUp is with the use of Thea Material Lab, that help us create new materials, edit the existing ones, or select a ready-to-use material from the available libraries. We can open Thea Material Lab either by selecting the last of the available presets, or by pressing the Edit in MATLAB button that we see at the bottom of the Material tab, or by double-clicking on the desired material with Thea cursor. Let's double-click on the water material of the pool. As we see, the Material Lab consists of several panels. Below the material preview, we can see all the available options that allow us to edit our material. At the left, we have the browser with the available material libraries, while at the right side we see the texture lab and the existing procedurals. We see here the preview of the existing water material. The SketchUp texture has been added to the diffuse slot, while the material transparency can be handled by the clipping panel. We can now edit this material according to our needs, or we can simply select one ready-to-use material from our libraries. We go to the browser, to the liquids folder, we select the material we want, we double-click on it or drag and drop it, and we replace the existing material with a new one. We accept the changes, we close the material lab, and we see that the new material is being used for our water at the pool. Keep in mind that whenever you want, you can go back to the SketchUp material by right-clicking on its preview and press the Remove Thea Material button. Apart from using the Thea Material Lab to browse our libraries as we just saw, we can use instead the Thea Coden browser, which opens if we click on the second button of the Thea toolbar. This is the Thea Coden browser, and within it we can see not only the material, but also the model and sky libraries, and the content of any other custom folder that we want. By selecting each folder, we can see at the right side the content of it with the available previews. Let's see how we can add one of these materials inside SketchUp. We may want to change, for example, the stone material used at our yard. We go to Thea browser, we select one library with corresponding materials, for example the exterior pavements library, and we select the material we want. We then double-click on it, and as we see, the material is now loaded inside SketchUp paint bucket, and we can easily paint now the desired surfaces in the same way that we would do with any other SketchUp material. By making a render, we can see that indeed the new material is being used. As you see, Thea Coden browser is a very powerful tool that allows us to browse and apply easily our materials. Finally, an additional way to add Thea materials inside SketchUp scene is with the use of the SketchUp paint bucket. All the materials of Thea libraries have been converted to the corresponding SketchUp materials and can be found within the paint bucket libraries. As you can see, two new folders exist here named Thea materials and Thea license materials. So, you can select the material you want and paint your models as you would do with any other SketchUp material. Then, during rendering, the corresponding Thea material with all its available features is being used. Note that you can easily convert your existing Thea materials to the corresponding SketchUp materials by using the Convert Thea Materials button that can be found inside the Thea Tools window at the Tools tab. Depending on your needs, you can follow the way that it's more convenient to you in order to apply Thea materials inside SketchUp. Once you are satisfied with the materials and the whole scene setup, you can make any further adjustments you want, like adding a background map for example, and start the final rendering. For more details on Thea for SketchUp plugin, you can visit our web page or contact us.